Hey, this is BJ from This Old Family Home. My goal is to give you the inspiration and motivation on how to start those home projects that you've been putting off. And this is part two. This is the second video of two parts of installing this handrail and balusters. In the first part, I had to go find the handrail and find the balusters, find the newel post. And in this video, I'll be installing it. It took a while, but I think it looks pretty good. All right, here we go. Here's the layout. There's gonna be a newel post at the bottom. There's a handrail that's gonna go up. All the balusters are gonna terminate into the bottom of this knee wall. This is called a knee wall. Basically, someone in the 80s came in and ripped out all the majestic parts of this house, including what used to be an octagonal newel post, presumably here, and a handrail that went all the way up with two balusters per stair. At the top, the handrail would wrap around with balusters along that landing and go on up to the third floor, all in one continuous handrail. I try not to think about that. Turns out I love handrails, and that is just like murdering a sacred cow or something. I worked to gather all the parts for the stair rail and balusters and the newel post for, it took about 12 visits to a handful of different architectural resale stores to find exactly what I was looking for. All right, time to work on installation. It's kind of hard to envision where the newel post is going to be. I've made my first chop into this knee wall, and I did an exploratory hole to figure out where the studs were. I will have to cut into the stair a little bit. The newel post is wider than the knee wall. I'm trying to get these pieces out, but not scratch the wood. They will be refinished, so that helps, but I don't want to cause any permanent damage. And I definitely don't want to touch the stairs. The stairs we're going to refinish as well, but I have a feeling they've been sanded before. These are most likely the original stairs, so that makes them 125 years old. I don't want to touch them. I don't want to hurt them. I don't know how to say this, but I kind of love old woodwork. I have quite a challenge in my way, and I'm not very happy about this 2x4, but it is legitimately a 2-inch by 4-inch piece of wood. Well, kind of. It's 2 1/8 by 3 3/4. I don't know if they were just having a bad day that day, but it is rock solid. Hey, you want to see how easy it is to cut through an old 2x4? Watch this. So easy. Just kidding. This thing is a monster. This is awesome. Let's see that again, because I didn't cut it short enough. All right, I'm taking a chunk out of the first stair, and it will accept the corner of the newel post. Woo! Look at that. Looks like those cuts were always there. Nope. Oh, that's looking good. Still so far to go, but man, it is going to look great. Okay, if you didn't know, stair rails are hard. Maybe it's just me. We're making a bit of a change, a bit of a pivot. Oh, you'll have to see it. And I'll have to see it. I'll have to figure it out, and then I can show it to you. Okay, I'm trying to get a good platform for the newel post to sit on, because the newel post has to be extremely rock solid. So I'm trying to get this gap level with the surrounding floor. So there's two pieces of OSB down there. There's a piece of 1x, and that gets me pretty much level. And now this board will go here, and now I have my platform. Now I'm just trying to figure out how to attach the newel post. Oh, we're getting more and more permanent here. Let's hope this is gonna turn out well. I think it will. Things are fitting pretty well considering those are all just scraps I found in the basement. All right, looks like it was supposed to go together this way. These are just scraps I found in the basement. But now I have a pretty solid chunk of wood that I can screw into from the basement. All right, I'm down here in the basement and I found I used 4 holes, 2 of them there, 2 of them there to help me find this location later, like right now. So I'm just going to drill a bunch of holes
Right now, the size of the bit that I'm using will be for the countersink because my 3-inch screws aren't quite long enough to get through all of the lumber. Oh yeah, that's the stuff. I think I found a new demoisturizer. Oh yeah.
I am putting some serious bolts into this Newel post because it is not going to go anywhere. I've got up to 6-inch bolts. I didn't know exactly which ones I were going to need. I was going to need, so I got a different sizes. So I'm going to put 5-inch and 6-inch. These are lag screws into this basement ceiling. Oh, and all the while, I keep going upstairs to make sure that the Newel post isn't getting out of plumb because I don't want to be shooting all these screws in there and then realizing that it's shifted.
So this is one of those times that you want to use an impact driver, an impact wrench, because it takes a ton of torque to screw in these big old lag screws. Oh, yes, that's awesome.
Video evidence that this thing used to be plumb. Hopefully still is. It's mostly plumb. Let's go with the answer we get on this side. It's a little more plumb. I like this answer better. Ooh, oh. I have about 6 big old lag screws, 6-inch lag screws coming up from the basement. That keeps it rock solid. Then I have 3 screws here. I have 2 on the other side. And man, this thing is, it's not going anywhere. It's going to be here for another 100 years. I'm installing this handrail by myself. And even if I did have someone else, it's going to help to have these holders, something to hold the handrail. All I did was I cut a 2x4 and I toenailed it in, got a little scrap piece of wood. I set up 2 of these assemblies, and this way I can rest the handrail. I can measure what the angles are going to be. I know that this is going to be a complex angle. It's going to be the angle of the stairs in this dimension. And then in this dimension, there's a little bit of another angle. Probably have the same on the top. I want to get it as close to flush as I can.
Yep, that's a railing behind me. That's a handrail. No big deal. I've only been working towards it for about 2 weeks now. On our way.
You'll never guess what it's time for. Well, lunch. I don't know how you would have known that. But then we're going to the hardware store. Woo!
Eek! I'm about to make the first cut. Here I go.
Made it in the first cut. What I had to do was, I've always suspected that my saw does not cut at the degree that it's marked at. And it turns out, I did a few practice cuts beforehand, and it's off by about 1 degree. So I would make a cut, and then actually measure it with the protractor that I just bought. And now I've got it really center aligned.
I had no idea how complicated this project was gonna be.
To say I'm apprehensive about this cut, cutting the rail down to length, would be an understatement. I just cut it a little short, a little long. I kept it a little long and on purpose. I want to make sure that this gets done correctly. So the angle is almost right. It's not perfect, but it is pretty close. All right, I think I'm ready to cut it, to attempt to cut it down to the actual length that will sit on the oak board.
Hey, this is BJ from This Old Family Home. Thanks for having me on Cribs. I wanted to show you today my new handrail. Woo! Bow, bow, bow.
Okay, I don't think I'm about to be on Cribs anytime soon. I think you have to have balusters to be on that show. All right, but I did cut it down to length. The angle looks adequate. I think it'll get sealed up the rest of the way with a few screws. So it looks pretty good from this side. Less good from that side, but it could be that the angle is a little off in one of the dimensions, and or it could be that the handrail twists. Hard to tell. But I'm gonna shoot a couple screws up through here and we're gonna be good. All right, now it's time to fasten the handrail to the Newel post in the top of the ceiling. And I've decided not to use construction adhesive. I'm only gonna use screws. If you're doing this, you should probably use construction adhesive. I don't think I can get it in cleanly. I think it's gonna leave a big smeary mess, and this stuff is not water-based, it's polyurethane-based, stuff that I wanna use. So I don't think I can get it up. So I'll put 3 screws in both the top and the bottom, and I think that'll hold. And if there's any, I'll also have the balusters to help with top up and down force. Here we go.
I'm gonna drill some pilot holes and make this go easier, less chances of splitting this, my precious handrail and my precious Newel post.
Oh my God, I can't believe this is happening. All right, so I got the top rail holder off. Last screw. Ta-da! A freestanding rail, except for the connections that are supposed to be there. Now with the rail in place, I can start working on some of the balusters. I need to cut the baluster spacers that'll go on the bottom and the baluster spacers that'll go on top.
Unboxing!
Unboxing! I bet you didn't know you were gonna get an unboxing video in the middle of this. Here, I ordered a table saw push stick because I have been improperly using my table saw, and table saw I truly believe is always looking for a way to cut your finger off. So,
check it.
All right, I cheated a little bit. I tore at the perforation as instructed. This is a push stick. The options were very limited on Amazon. I was looking for something fancy, and they do have fancy, but I was also looking for cheap, so. And this is magnetic, so apparently it's gonna stick on the side of my table saw. This is 10 bucks off of Amazon. It's called PowerTech. I'll let you know if it works. So you know how there's no failures, there's only learnings? Well, let's just say I'm learning a lot today and kind of relearning. So just if you're ever making a vertical measurement between two diagonal surfaces, I'm trying to measure the distance from where the tape measure touches the board in there. And I need to use the left side of the tape measure because of the diagonal. I was using the right side and I kept getting these balusters that were too short. When it's vertical, it's actually like that. It's too short. So I won't tell you how many times it happened, but it was more than once and less than 3 times. But I won't make that mistake again. This looks so easy, just cutting the right balusters and popping them in. But there's 2 issues. One is I need to have a 4-inch gap between balusters including at the narrowest point or at the widest point. So I need to go do some math. The second issue is I don't have a way to measure if this is straight up and down, if it's plumb. First, I'm gonna go tackle the math issue. I heard a rule of thumb somewhere that you can just make the diagonal spacers between the balusters at 5 inches and you'll end up with about 4 inches or less between the balusters, but that's not true in this case. All right, so I know that I needed less than 4 inches between the narrowest points of the balusters. So the way I backed into what this dimension needed to be. This needs to be cosine. Oh, well this is, hang on. So 3 3/4 times the cosine of 36 degrees is about 3. So 3 inches, it turns out, is what we want. If you need more explanation, you can ping me, or you can leave a message below. Ha! I said ping, like using communicator at work. So now if you want to get a hold of me, you can't ping me. If you want to get a hold of me, leave a message below. Contact me on Instagram, by the way. So I should have the math problem fixed. Now I need to make sure that the balusters are straight up and down, and that solution is a little easier than I expected. So I do have a little bit of the square part to check for a square. So this is not exactly square, which is how it looked visually. So I'll go take a little bit of the length off and we'll be good. Our house, in the middle of our street. Our house, in the middle of our house, it has a crowd. There's always something happening and it's usually quite loud. Our mom, she's so house proud. Isn't it nice when your map turns out to be correct? Check this out. We're at 3 7/8 of an inch, and it needs to be less than 4. So, booyah! All right, so I think I finally know how to do it. Now I just need to go crank through some of these. I think I'm gonna go make 3 of them, maybe 5 of them, and I'll put them together, make sure everything still goes together, and then I can just make a whole bunch of them. So I took a picture of my first 2 balusters and sent it to my wife, and she noticed that the second one was crooked. It really looked crooked in the photo. So I came back and I found a way to measure if it's actually plumb or not. It is plumb. But in the picture, it looked like it wasn't. I think it was just the wide angle lens on the iPhone. But the way to check it is I cut a 1x2. I took any board that was straight and I cut it to be the shape of one of the balusters, just the angle on either ends. And when I put the level up to it, that is level. That's pretty level. It's probably gonna change a little bit as I go, so I can change it as I go based on the baluster spacers. But right now, that is level. All right, I actually had enough forethought to clamp down a block onto the chop saw, as you can see, and that way I can repeatedly make the same dimension cut over and over again, because that's the point that I'm at. I had to do that for the baluster spacers on the top and bottom, and now I've done it for 8 of the balusters. Every time I do this, I do a few more. I'm still a little hesitant to cut through all of them just in case I make a mistake. And as I go, I'll cut them to length. There's a little bit of that the height of the rail changes just a little bit as it goes up. Our house. I'm actually making a little bit of progress today. Feels good. It does not usually happen. Just so you can see up close what I'm doing, there is the bottom baluster spacer that goes in. There is the top baluster spacer that goes in. And both of them I put glue and I put one brad nail into. The brad nail might be overdoing it. And then I pop in the baluster. Boom. All right, back to work. It all comes down to this. The final baluster, it's in! Woo! Woo! Ah, I did it! Oh my God, that was the longest project ever. Okay, not the longest project ever, but I really thought that was gonna take 1 week and it took about 2.5. But it's done and it looks awesome. It's not painted, but here, I'll take some pictures of it. This project was, I'm very, very happy with it. And I love talking about handrails. If you've done a handrail project, installed balusters, somehow made your stairs safer, let me know. You can let me know on Instagram or leave comments below on YouTube. So please give a thumbs up if this is helpful. Subscribe so you can get more videos like this, and just reach out. I want to hear from you. My goal is to give you the confidence and motivation to start the home project that you've been putting off. So let me know if I'm doing that or how I can do that. All right, I'll see you next time. Bye.